Hey Taurus, how are you? This is Born With a Veil. This is your reading from February the 1st to February the 10th, 2020. We'll see what's going on with you. If you'd like a reading, please go to Cash App, Born With a Veil. There. If you'd like a reading, please call me at 313-401-3707. My phone readings are $120. I have a $40 tarot card reading, full reading, one card 15, five card 25, and 15 card 35. So you go to Cash App, $ Born With a Veil. Please call me at 313-401-3707 and text me and let me know that you did pay for a reading, and then I'll get in contact with you then, okay? So let's get on with your reading, Taurus. Before I start, I do not own the rights to this music or copyrights to this music. I'm just playing jazz in the background. Thank you so much. If you want to know who this is, her name is Stacy Kent, K-E-N-T. She's really smooth. I like her. Tis Autumn is her album. So we have the Strength card. Taurus, you have a weakness at this time and you are acting petty. What's going on, Taurus? Some male Tauruses are impotent. They can't get it up. Some Tauruses are sick at this time. Either there's something mentally going on with them or they're just literally sick. Entertainment purposes only. Taurus has a lack of faith at this time because they're confused. They really don't know what they want to do. And some Tauruses are abusing their power within a relationship. And there's a lot of temptation with Taurus and a lot of indifference. So the Nine of Swords, entertainment purposes only, but some of you have had a miscarriage. Some of you are in a miserable marriage or relationship. There's a lot of other men and women that want to date you, want to see you, but you have a concern with that because of sexually transmitted disease, or you just don't trust, period. There is a lot of quarreling within your relationship. You're very unhappy. You have anxiety over this person you're married to or you're in love with, or you don't love them at all, but there's still a lot of anxiety. You have a lot of worry, despair within this relationship. You are suffering in this relationship and you can't sleep, period. Then you got the Ace of Coins. You have some money. I'm not saying you're rich, but you're not happy. Even though you're working, you're not happy with this person. You're miserable. You wasted a lot of money. You misused a lot of money, or people took advantage of you because of your money. There's corruption by money. And Taurus, when it comes to money, is a foe. We love money, okay? Tauruses can be greedy to a certain extent with money. So you got the Fool. Somebody's going to make a faulty choice. I feel there's a three-way love affair. Somebody's going to make a faulty choice, pick the wrong person. That is a bad decision. You're going to hesitate about who you're going to pick. Make sure you make the right decision. You're going to make an indecision. It's going to affect the rest of your life. Some Tauruses are shy to a certain extent too. Then you got the Nine of Coins. Tauruses love the outside. They don't like to be made to stay in. They don't like to be. Their thing is shelter. They got to have a sheltered environment. They have to have everything the way they know that they're praying for, they're perfecting for. You know, they got to have a vehicle. They got to have a house. They got to have money in their pockets. I mean, hey, this is a way of life. You have to have these things. You do love nature. Some of you are okay with money. Some of you are still working hard, though, for it, too. You got the Six of Cups. You got a lot of opportunities coming ahead, Taurus. Future looks great. Coming events. You're going to be having fun this summer. New vistas are coming. Something that you're planning may fail, but it will shortly arrive. It could be moving. It could be anything, new relationship, old relationship. It's not working out so much right now, but it will in the end. You got the Queen of Cups, Taurus. You're a very warm-hearted person, very fair person. You are beloved and adored by the opposite sex. You are a good friend. If you have children, you're a good mother. You are very devoted when you are with someone, very honest and loving and intelligent. And some of you are psychic. Then you got the Ace of Swords. This relationship you're in is a disaster, self-destruction. Either they got a violent temper or you got a violent temper, and both of those tempers are not good together. And somebody is cheating in this relationship. Then you got the Three of Cups. There is going to be a resolution at the end, most definitely. Something happening in February, March, April, with a relationship. Either leaving the relationship, but there's going to be a resolution of a problem, maybe with someone from your past. You got some healing to do, Taurus, very much so. You got to learn to compromise. And somebody that you haven't talked to is women. With yourself in there, so there's two other women that maybe you fell out or you're not speaking to are going to come together. Okay. You got your soulmate. What's up? Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help. So you do have your soulmate. You can feel it. Some of you have called it in, and some of you have been with your soulmate for a while. Trust. Taurus has a hard time trusting, because they've been fucked over for so long in a lot of relationships. And they want to trust you, but they know deep down in their heart that they can't trust you because you're a liar, you're a cheater. You're talking to other women, you're writing other women, you're leading women on, and that's some shit that Taurus just can't deal with. The chemistry, there's a strong magnetic attraction. Now, I will tell you this, if it's a three-way love affair, the second person, there is chemistry there. Absolutely. A lot of chemistry. She can't resist you. Do you see her face? It's just when you go to touch her or just next to her, she just can't resist you. There's a sexual chemistry, passionate, romantic between you two. She can't let it go. Or he can't let it go. Past life relationship. You have known each other before. So yes, the person that you really do love, you've known each other before. And the sex was great back then. The passion and the romance was great back then. The bedroom game, you were getting it on, Taurus, and whoever. Then getting to know each other. I feel there's a three-way love affair there. You see her at the bottom. She's like disgusted. She's tired. It could be a man too. But somebody's got to make a decision here. Codependency. Taurus says drink a lot. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. They like to eat a lot too. Smoke a lot. Indulge. And once again, there could be a sexual addiction here too. Taurus male, Taurus female. Very soon, things are about to change for you, Taurus, in a good way. Give your relationship a chance. If it's a three-way love affair, I always say, people that cheat, if you pick the second person, that's the one you're supposed to be with. Because if you love the first one, you wouldn't cheat in the first place. Keep an open mind. There's a three-way love affair. Men, two women. Women, two men. Children. So one of you or both of you have children. And engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. So a lot of you are engaged. Retreat. You want to take your lover and you just want to run off and go somewhere and disconnect from every damn body. Unrequited love. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So whoever you're married to or involved with, there's just not enough attraction anymore. You're looking at his punk ass like, I wish you'd stop kissing me. Ain't nothing happening in the bedroom. See ya. Bye. You don't know what you're doing. Passion. But this other person that you have passion with, the love, you just can't keep your hands off each other. Wedding. Yep, some of you are married. You got to learn to forgive, Taurus. Learn to forgive and move on. But some of you are in a marriage where you just can't forgive anymore. You're just done. You're done, period. And then you got stay optimistic about your love life. Some of you are still trying to stay optimistic. You know, you're trying so hard. Now, Taurus, you're dealing with another Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Check your Venus, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Could be Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces, too. So, healing family issues. I think both the parties, if it's a third party, all of you need some healing. All of you need some healing within your own families and with your own self. And then, if you're having a third way, you and your lover need some healing. Some of you got to release that ex. And your last card is, you have to love yourself first. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. Once you love yourself and you let all that bullshit go, that man or woman is going to be so more attracted to you. Okay? So it's all free will, Taurus, to figure out what you want to do in your life. Okay? So this is Born with a Veil. God bless. Please like, share, and subscribe.